Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our host for tonight, Miss Valerie Vella.
Good evening, Honourable Parliamentary Secretary Silvio Schembri, MCA Chairman, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Chairman of and the Board of Directors of the Malta Communications Authority, I welcome you to the 7th edition of the MCA E-Business Awards. And to start off this evening, we are very delighted to introduce you to a unique personality tonight. We are truly happy that the MCA E-Business Awards have received public recognition from an internet pioneer. I'm sure he needs no introduction. He's Google's chief internet evangelist, and he is widely known as one of the fathers of the internet. Please allow us to present a short biographical video and a short address after. Let's watch this together.
Widely known as the father of the internet, Vent Cerf is an American engineer by profession who, along with Bob Kahn, has co-invented the TCP/IP during his time at DARPA, the US Department of Defense, and Advanced Research Projects Agency. What sounds like a humble protocol actually constitutes the fundamental architecture of the internet, which today's staple technologies, including the Wi-Fi, email, 3G and 4G, the World Wide Web, as well as all applications that drive on these technologies, operate. For his seminal and pioneering contribution to the advancement of technology and humanity, Dr. Cerf has received numerous prestigious awards, including the Nobel Prize equivalent for computer science, the ACM Alan M. Turing Award, the US National Medal of Technology, and the Presidential Medal of Freedom, the latter two directly from two former US presidents. Dr. Cerf is also the founder of the Internet Society, a leading advocate for free and open internet to all people throughout the world. Today, Dr. Cerf serves as the Vice President and Chief Internet Evangelist for Google, a position he occupied since 2005. At Google, he is entrusted with identifying new enabling technologies that support innovative internet-based products and services. The MCA is not only extremely honored by Dr. Cerf's endorsement of this edition of the E-Business Awards, but is also encouraged to continue organizing these awards for the benefit of the local ICT and business communities in the years to come.
My name is Vint Cerf. I'm Google's chief internet evangelist, and I'm sorry I can't join you in person, so I'm afraid you'll have to put up with virtual Vint. I learned recently about the Malta e-commerce awards and more generally the program of education in information and communication technologies, and I want to offer my strongest encouragement to continue these programs. It's hard to overestimate the potential value of training in information and communication technologies, particularly as we start looking at opportunities on a global scale. Even the smallest of countries could reach global markets, assuming that you create applications that are suitable for people who are living around the world. Keep in mind that rather than focusing solely on a domestic opportunity, think about the rest of the world's GDP. It's enormous. No one country has a GDP anything like the rest of the world. So the consequence of that is that opportunities are extraordinary for the creation of new businesses that take advantage of the global internet and the reach that that it provides. So having people in Malta learning about online technologies, about software and programming, about applications that can enhance business opportunities has to be a very smart move. And of course, recognizing people who have done well in this space so as to encourage others to pursue this is equally important. So I congratulate the winners of the E-Business Awards and hope very much that I'll be learning more about your successes as time goes on. And while we don't get to see each other face to face, perhaps we'll cross paths on the net.
That was indeed an honor and a surprise for us all tonight. And we are also proud to confirm that for the second year, the MCA E-Business Awards are affiliated with the prestigious World Summit Awards that are organized under the auspices of the United Nations. Last year, three of our local nominees made it to the WSA shortlist, and that indeed is quite an achievement. Now, we are also happy to tell you that for the first time ever, we will share this ceremony with a wider audience because this ceremony tonight will be live streamed on the MCA Facebook page. So you can all follow it there. And now some brief house rules for tonight. At the end of the ceremony, all winners will be invited here on stage for a commemorative photo and also for a short interview. We also urge you to use the hashtag so we can spread the word together. And we inform you that our photos and videos will be uploaded on social media later on. So, tonight's finalists and winners were selected by three adjudicating committees, comprising representatives from the industry, the government, and the academia. All nominations were adjudicated against specific criteria developed for each category, respectively. For example, value added for users, administrative gain for the solution owners, user experience, functionality, and innovation. As in previous years, we will be handing out these beautiful trophies just here behind me. We will be giving one to the owner and one to the developer of each winning solution. And as usual this year, we have received a large number of nominations, so you can imagine how hard it was for the adjudicating committees to come up with the winners tonight. May I take this opportunity to congratulate all finalists and non-finalists who are here tonight for their achievements. Ladies and gentlemen, please give all participants a big round of applause. Indeed, they all did great work. So, I'm sure that now you are all very excited to see who the winners will be in each category. So, good luck to all finalists, and let's move on and start with the first category. This is the category for the best use of technology in business transformation. This category awards the best integrated applications designed to record and manage enterprise data and resources, leading to huge improvements in the efficiency and effectiveness of any organization. Let's watch this video with all the finalists in this category.
Best use of technology in business transformation. C-Track of Mater Dei Hospital, developed by Cursor Limited. Lux Airport of Luxembourg Airport, developed by Icon. Multigas Power BI of Multigas Limited, developed by KPMG Crimson Wing.
So, those are the three finalists for this category, and I would now like to invite here on stage the Honourable Silvio Schembri, Parliamentary Secretary for Financial Services, Digital Economy and Innovation, to present this award. Congratulations. You can take the podium, it's all yours.
Thank you, Valeria. I'm honored here tonight to present this award and the best use of technology in business transformation. And the winner of the best use of technology in business transformation is Lux Airport, developed by Icon.
Take the podium for a short message. The podium is all yours. Okay, no message this time, but if any of the winners would like to deliver a short message, the podium is there for you to go. Now, let's watch a video to show us all about this winning solution.
Best use of technology in business transformation. Lux Airport of Luxembourg Airport by Icon. Airports are increasingly challenged to improve travelers' experience and provide innovative solutions to support today's age of connected travelers. Now that the solution has been deployed, travelers arriving and departing from Lux Airport will be able to plan their trips better, decide on the best method to get to the airport, and optimize their time while at the airport, whether it's enjoying a delicious lunch or buying presents for their loved ones. This innovative end-to-end digital solution will give visitors an excellent experience that extends beyond the airport terminal.
So, congratulations again to Luxembourg Airport and Icon. And next up, it's the Best App category, which awards an entity that has successfully introduced a mobile or tablet application. With millions of free and paid apps available across a variety of operating platforms and even more downloads of these apps, we are indeed witnessing a revolution in mobile access to content of every kind. User-friendliness, design, and interactivity are key to an app's uptake and success. So, let's see the finalists for the best app.
Best app. Free Hour. Kickdish. Icchavetta of Paulo Freire Institute and Vodafone Malta Foundation. Developed by BB Associates, MaltaServe Limited.
The three finalists for the best app, and this award is sponsored by Malta Post. And therefore, I would like to invite on stage Mr. Joe Gaffa, Chief Executive Officer of Malta Post, to announce the winner of this award.
First of all, I wish to congratulate Malta Communication Authority, led by Dr. Woods, for this annual initiative. It's an important initiative for the whole industry. And the award for the best app goes to Icchavetta of Vodafone and Paulo Freire Institute, developed by BB Associates.
Congratulations to our winners, the Paulo Freire Institute, Vodafone, and BB Associates, MaltaServe Limited. Well done, and before you leave the stage, a message to our audience. Please, the podium is all yours.
The idea behind this app is to help people to be more in touch with society, to make available to everyone our Maltese language, which we are proud of. There are many people who speak very well in Maltese, but this app will help them even more to communicate. So for them, we dedicate this prize. And thank you very much for everybody, for the Vodafone Malta Foundation, who have sponsored for all the developers and everyone. Thank you very much.
Thank you, and well done to you all. Thank you. And now we can watch a video clip to see what this winning solution is all about.
Best App, Ichavetta of Vodafone Malta Foundation and Paulo Freire Institute by BB Associates Limited, MaltaServe. Ichavetta is an app created by the Vodafone Malta Foundation and the Paulo Freire Institute and developed by MaltaServe. It is essentially a Maltese literacy toolkit targeted at adults and youths facing social exclusion and employment challenges. The toolkit is structured like a course and contains a set of 32 interactive activities, starting off at an elementary level and becoming progressively more advanced to allow the user to acquire basic reading and writing skills in Maltese. Ichavetta is currently the only existing resource aimed at teaching basic literacy skills in Maltese, which is specifically targeted at youths and adults. It is based on Paulo Freire Institute's several years of work in the field of education and in helping adults with literacy. The overarching aim of Ichavetta is to be the key to employment opportunities, greater confidence and well-being, and ultimately, a higher standard of living.
Congratulations to our winners there, and well done, well done. And now we move on to the next category. This is the best B2B application. This award recognizes the best provider of an ICT-enabled supply chain management system, streamlining of operations, reducing overhead costs, and minimizing human error are a few of the benefits of this solution. Let's see who the finalists for the best B2B solutions are.
Best B2B application. Effectly, developed by MIC3 International. Reach Energy Management Platform, developed by ESDL Limited. eSeller of Multipost, developed by Ascent Software.
And now that we know who the three finalists for this category are, I would like to join me here on stage, Mr. Harold Roche, the Chief Executive Officer of Melita. This award is sponsored by Melita. Please.
Hello, everybody. So thank you very much for the honor to be here to be able to present this award. And let me now open immediately the envelope. The winner is Effectly. Congratulations.
Congratulations to our winners. MIC3 International for the winning product, Effectly. Congratulations. And now a short message from one of you, please. Thank you, Mr. Rush.
Good evening. First of all, we're very humbled and thank you very much for this acknowledgement. On behalf of MRC3, we'd like to thank MCA for this acknowledgement of our effort. And we truly feel that this is giving us the boost that we need to also show what our application can do. We are currently providing services to 26,000 sites and 288,000 endpoints. This is a show of the dedication of a team that has been built in Malta that is going worldwide and is truly taking the Internet of Things and smart workplaces to a new height. We are very, very proud of the team. Well, I am very proud of the team, and thank you very much for this acknowledgement. We really appreciate it. Thank you.
Well done. Teamwork is always the best. Well done. Congratulations. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's watch a short video to see what this winning solution was all about.
Best B2B. Effectly by MIC3. MIC3's Effectly is a revolutionary IoT contextual collaboration platform that supports the entire operation environment of organizations, people, and things, including how these relate to those outside and around the core, business, customers, vendors, suppliers, regulators, and stakeholders. Effectly collects information from a myriad of signal-generating devices, processes the data through its rules engine, executing processes according to organization-specific processes or applications. The processes will entail tasks that are assigned to profile owners. The tasks are communicated in context within a communications platform that ensures the most effective communication amongst the participants is delivered, whether through live chat, structured forms, free text, or including media and documentation supporting the successful completion of the task. The business is provided with situational awareness through maps with live and drillable data represented in space and geolocation. The organization is also provided with real-time and predictive analytics that are designed and modified according to the organization's needs, giving the right person the right information at the right time to react to and preempt emerging situations.
Well done to MIC3 again with the product, Effectly. And on to the fourth award for tonight. This is the award for the best e-commerce website. This award recognizes the website that has excelled in creating a simple yet holistic consumer experience. Online shopping by the Maltese internet users has been increasing constantly over the years, and local businesses are responding to this demand by investing in the online market and taking their business to another level. Let's see who the finalists are.
Best e-commerce website. Love in Malta. Fab Valletta, developed by Growth Gurus. UniversityLanguagesSchool.com of Malta University Language School, developed by CSIS.
Another three finalists, and this award is offered by Vodafone. With pleasure, I invite on stage to present this award one of the directors of Vodafone Malta, Mr. Jason Pavia.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's truly a privilege for me to be here today on behalf of Vodafone to present this award at such a prestigious event. I'd like to congratulate the MCA for organizing this award and also all the nominees for being here tonight. So, I'll announce the winner with the drum roll. So, the winner of the best e-commerce website is Fab Valletta by Growth Gurus.
Our winners are enjoying the red carpet, taking it calmly. Well done and congratulations, you deserve it. Well done. Well done. A short message from one of you, the podium is yours if you want to.
Thank you very much. Thank you to the MCA for hosting this very prestigious event. Congratulations to all the winners who have already won and who are going to win, and everyone who's been finalized. Working with FabLab, their tagline was "Create almost anything." Now that was quite daunting when they come to you saying, "We need an e-commerce solution," and our tagline is "Create almost anything." They did push us to push the boundaries of what's possible. What's beautiful about FabLab, and Sean will continue to tell you a bit more, is there's 1,200 FabLabs across the world. It's a global organization. And the Maltese FabLab has the only FabLab website where you can actually book machines for 1 hour or 2 hours to create anything you want. So Malta's at the heart of innovation, and I think that's true in many different industries in the country, and we're very proud to be a part of it.
I won't take much of your time. First of all, thank you very much for whoever believed in us. As Josh said, we are one single node in a multifaceted enterprise, which is representing Industry 4.0, which is basically the new generation of manufacturing. The Fab Lab is there for all of you guys to, you know, take advantage of. We have available resources, machines, and soft skills in advanced digital design and fabrication. So if you're into DIY and want to, you know, create something of your own instead of buying it, you should pop over or contact us, and you know, we can help you out and figure out the best way of making your ideas come to life. So yeah, thank you everyone for this.
That's cool. Very well done. Congratulations. And let's see a short clip to see exactly what this website has to offer.
Best B2C. Fab Valletta of Fab Lab Valletta by Growth Gurus. A gift of empowerment through an e-commerce website that enables people to learn, make, invent, and innovate in a collaborative and global network. With 1,200 Fab Labs across 30 countries, only one owns an e-commerce website that provides the fundamentals to a customer-centric solution to enable anyone to fabricate their vision. That's Fab Lab Valletta by Growth Gurus. A Fab Lab is a technical prototyping platform for innovation and invention, providing stimulus for local entrepreneurship. The new Fab Lab e-commerce website extends this brand mission to an online audience. It has dramatically streamlined the promotion, booking, scheduling, project management, and client engagement in using our machinery, workspaces, and tools. The platform features an integrated calendar that shows all the availabilities in real time and enables user-specified time slot bookings for each of our digital fabrication technologies, including laser cutters, 3D printers, VR headsets, and workspaces.
Congratulations to Fab Valletta by Growth Gurus. Well done. And ladies and gentlemen, we are halfway through this award ceremony. I would like to remind you that after it all ends, I would like to invite here all the winners for a commemorative photo and a short interview. So don't forget that. Don't leave before coming here to take the photo. And I would also like to tell you that following last year's success, the MCA once again opened the best social media campaign category to a public vote, giving you, the public, a say in who takes the top place. We must say that we had an exciting tie between three very valid finalists. And indeed, the 50% public vote was decisive in determining the final outcome of this award. However, about this, we'll tell you more later on. Let's move on to the next category. The next category now is the Academic Award. As mentioned earlier on, the MCA has the pleasure to award the best ICT academic dissertation with an e-business theme. This award recognizes exceptional research that is conducted by graduates specializing in e-business and which sheds new light on the potential of e-business practices. Let's see who the finalists are.
Best ICT academic dissertation with an e-business theme. How Big Data Analytics Helps Improve Business Performance by Emma Megan Tranter. Investigating the Potential of Big Data in the Management of Traffic in Malta by Nigel Patch. The Effect of Local News on the Maltese Stock Market, an Empirical Evaluation Using Machine Learning by Francesca Gauci.
So, those are the three finalists for the Academic Award. And this award is sponsored by HSBC. And to present this award, I would like to invite here on stage Mr. Edwin Balzan, Senior Digital Marketing Manager at HSBC Malta.
First of all, in name of HSBC, I would like to thank the MCA, who has been organizing this event since 2015, that has been growing steadily. And I'm honored to be alongside so many creators of technology here. And so now Let me present the award for the best ICT academic project with a new business team. And the winner is Francesca Gauci.
I definitely didn't think that I would make it this far, definitely with all the stress that a dissertation comes with. I would like to thank, first of all, the MCA and the Faculty of Economics, Management and Accountancy at the University of Malta, who has provided me with the tools to actually carry out this dissertation. I hope that there are more opportunities for students to delve into fintech and machine learning in the future. And most, I would like to thank my supervisor, Dr. Godwin Caruana, who has stuck with me for the whole year and has provided me with both moral and academic support. Thank you.
Congratulations. Good luck for your career, and never say never. Now, let's see the video showing us what this dissertation was all about.
Best academic dissertation with an e-business theme. Dissertation title, The Effect of Local News on the Maltese Stock Market, an Empirical Evaluation Using Machine Learning, Francesca Gauci. Stock market predictability has been a long-standing issue in financial research and practice. This dissertation investigates the possibility of finding patterns within the Maltese stock market using a synthesis of linguistic and statistical methods. In particular, this work applies text mining and machine learning to determine the performance of different supervised prediction models and the predictive power of non-quantifiable news articles for future market movement. Different keyword extraction methods are used to identify terms that provide a clear description of the article content. Each news instance is labeled either as a rise or drop based on the change in the Malta Stock Exchange, MSE index. The results of this experiment contribute towards an empirical appraisal of the application of various learning algorithms in correlating news stories with fluctuations in the MSE index. Results were corroborated with experts from the finance domain, and it is established that the proposed methodology is substantially reflective of the true dynamics of the Maltese market.
Congratulations again, Francesca Gauci. And the next category is the best tech startup. This category recognizes the Malta-based startup with the highest potential for international growth. These startups leverage on technology to scale internationally. Consideration was given to unique selling points, use of technology, team strength, and target market size. Let's see who the finalists are.
Best tech startup, Altaro, EBO, AC Automated Controllers.
The three finalists, and to announce the winner and present the award for the best tech startup, I would like to invite here on stage Ms. Carla Marie Vella, Consult XD.
Good evening. Last year I had the honor of meeting over 500 startups in the European landscape. It's an absolute pleasure and honor to recognize that last year alone, 90 of those startups were coming from Malta. It always puts me in an awkward position when I meet tech startups. Why? I feel like I'm the most stupid person in the room. And this is just an absolute honor for me to stand here tonight and present Malta's tech startup for this year. So, drum roll please. And the winner is Altaro.
message. You're the king.
I would like to thank the MCA first of all, but what I would like to thank mostly is the team at Altaro. We have been growing quite well, and we wouldn't have been doing that if it wasn't the team we have in Malta. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Well done to Altaro. And let's learn something more about this startup.
Best tech startup. Altaro Limited. Altaro VM Backup is a hassle-free virtual machine backup software solution for Hyper-V and VMware. Our solution is a fast, affordable, high performer, and especially developed for small and mid-market businesses. We've cut the waste and hassle to give customers an agile, streamlined solution that is easy to implement, feature-rich, backed with an outstanding support as part of the package. The intuitive interface of the solution allows end users to set up and perform backups and restores easily. Altaro VM Backup is affordably priced per host and not per socket, CPU or VM, and backed by outstanding support.
Congratulations again to Altaro. Well done. And this brings us to the penultimate award of the night, the Best Social Media Campaign. Indeed, social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, YouTube are economic and effective marketing tools which allow businesses to promote their products or services and attract new customers. This award recognizes that entity which has made the best use of its social media platforms to interact and to offer added value to its consumers. And once again, this year, as I told you before, the public vote had the final say. Let's see.
Best Social Media Campaign. EU2017.MT, developed by Etoile Partners Malta. Malta Elections Social Scoreboard by Icon. Love and Malta April Fool's Campaign.
So, three finalists for this award as well. And to present this award, it is my pleasure to invite here on stage Dr. Edward Woods, Chairman of the Malta Communications Authority.
Honorable Shkembri, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here. Sponsors, thank you as well. And I'd like to congratulate all nominees. And the winner of the Best Social Media Campaign is...
Suspense.
Shall I?
Yes, please.
I'm not sure I can read it. Love in Malta.
Congratulations, and who of you will deliver the message? They all point to each other, huh? Nobody wants to do it.
Thank you very, very much. I really want to thank, first of all, the amazing team of Love in Malta that really got together to produce this April Fool's joke that we did last year. Thanks to our video partners, V Squared, as well, for being so integral in everything that we do. Thanks to all the celebrities who endorsed our political party as well, ranging from this year's Eurovision winner to the Prime Minister, Joseph Muscat, as well, last year. And thanks to the political parties for making it, for setting the bar so low to allow us to make such a splash with our fake political party. So thank you very, very much, MCA as well.
Congratulations, Love in Malta, and let's learn more about the social media campaign by watching this short clip.
Best Social Media Campaign, 50% People's Choice. April Fool's Campaign by Love in Malta. Love in Malta's audacious April Fool's Campaign saw the online news and entertainment platform officially registering as a political party and proposing a detailed electoral manifesto that got widespread coverage across national news media. The campaign generated thousands of euros worth of PR space and reached more than 600,000 Facebook users, while capturing the island's attention and positioning Love in Malta as a legitimate source of political commentary. The 360 campaign combined PR, social media, video, music, radio, social media influencers, web platforms and crowdfunding to create an unforgettable campaign that exceeded objectives despite a zero budget. The campaign also served a social function by raising awareness about important political issues, putting voters directly in contact with candidates in their district, and providing a critique of the political parties in Malta while keeping everything as entertaining as possible.
Done to Love in Malta, and this brings us to the last award for tonight. It's the Best E-Government Initiative. Indeed, the use of information and communication technology can effectively improve and enhance the efficiency and effectiveness of service in the public sector. These initiatives contribute to simplifying bureaucratic processes and cut administrative costs and connect citizens. Let's see the finalists for this award, the Best E-Government Initiative.
Best E-Government Initiative. CPA SMS of Mater Dei Hospital, developed by Cursor Limited. Service.gov of OPM, developed by Exergy Limited. Free Childcare System of Jobs Plus, developed by AIS Software.
Three finalists again for this last category of tonight, and this award is sponsored by Go. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage Mr. Antonio Ivankovic, Chief of Customer Experience from Go, who will present this award to our winners. Hi.
Thank you. Dear Chairman, dear attendees, it's my personal and great Go's honor to stand in front of you and to announce today's award that is in the category of Best E-Government Initiative. Drum rolls. And the winner of the Best Government Initiative is CPSMS of Mater Dei Hospital.
Congratulations to Mater Dei Hospital and Cursor Limited. A message from you, please. Thank you.
Thank you for having us here. Thank you, MCA, for organizing this. Thank you for recognizing the little efforts that we do. A special thanks goes to the team, Celia, Sharon, and the developers who always manage to transform one liners into deliverable projects that benefit the hospital and our patients. Thank you so much.
Thank you, thank you. Little efforts make big things usually. Well done, congratulations. And Let us watch the short video clip about this winning solution.
Best e-government initiative. CPA SMS of Mater Dei Hospital by Cursor Limited. Text messaging has become one of the most used media in communication. Mater Dei Hospital has implemented CPA SMS, an electronic messaging system, SMS, where reminders are sent to people with outpatients appointments through SMS. People are set to be reminded of their appointments 10 days and 2 days respectively prior to their hospital visitation. One of the biggest advantages of this system is the reduction of missed appointments. One third of no-shows is a result of people forgetting about their appointments. In the first month of the system's inception, the total number of missed appointments has subsequently been reduced by 11%. This equates to some 20,000 appointments in a year, or a cost avoidance of 1.9 million euros worth of specialist multidisciplinary teams, consultants, doctors, nurses, etc. working hours. As a result of CPA SMS, waiting lists are being cut down drastically in certain outpatient clinics. In an acute hospital environment, this means that the solution is actually improving health outcomes and saving lives. CPA SMS is currently being rolled out to all hospitals and clinics that fall under the remit of the Ministry of Health.
Congratulations again to Mater Dei Hospital and Cursor Limited. And now I would like to invite here once again the Parliamentary Secretary, the Honourable Silvio Shkembri, to come on stage to deliver a short address, please.
Thank you, Valerie, distinguished guest, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. It is an honour and a pleasure for me to be here with you tonight this evening at the 7th edition of the MCAA Business Awards. Although this is my first time at these awards, I could easily be captivated by the audience present here and the eagerness of all finalists to see their solutions winning is a clear reflection of the passion and pride that the men and women in this industry have for the professional vocation. So I indeed wish to congratulate all winners tonight for the outstanding solutions they presented. I also would like to commend the works of the other finalists who, although did not win today, still have put forward nominations to the highest caliber. As Dr. Self has rightly pointed out earlier on, the global internet has empowered even the smallest of nations to tap opportunities on a global scale. And tonight, I am pleased to observe that some of the winning solutions have, in fact, already been internationalized, while others have a very good potential to be on that path as well. This gives me the affirmation that our strive to steer our economy into a modern digital era is on the right track and is already producing results on the ground. And that's not only because a functional digital economy creates value and wealth for the business owners, their employees, and citizens at large, but equally so does not exert disproportionate pressure on our already very limited resources and natural environment as other industries stand doing. All this doesn't mean that we do not have challenges to overcome. Other jurisdictions are actively vying for our economic top spots and are ready to take them at the first viable opportunity. So it is here where we may need to fight out corner, and agility is everything in this game for survival. The pace at which the ICT industry evolves is empowered by other types of industries, and unless we respond swiftly, we as policymakers and you as entrepreneurs are all bound to lose out to these competing countries. Indeed, since VinServ's groundbreaking time when the first digital message were beamed across the web, the ICT industry has leapfrogged, and today we are on the doorstep of the next industrial revolution. Noteworthy is the fact that over a century has actually elapsed between the first and the second industrial revolution, and almost a century between the second and the third. So time spans between major industrial revolutions have shrunk significantly. giving humanity limited time to adjust to major changes. The reaction of society to such changes differs widely across and within its many levels. There's no doubt, for example, that today digital natives consume technology differently from their grandparents and even from their parents. As policymakers, we have the responsibility that no one falls back in this pathway. Hence, the need to devise initiatives aimed at mitigating any undesired impacts of any technological development on vulnerable sectors of our society. This is a bold mandate that the Information Society Unit within MCA has. It is a mandate that the MCA has been consolidating through the launch of its first strategic vision for public consultation, that is in the coming few weeks. Nowadays, hardly a day passes when someone vilifies or reveres cryptocurrencies. But what is key at this chapter of history is the technology that drives these currencies rather than the currency itself. The potential of blockchain through proper massive developments in all sectors of our lifetime, from IoT to artificial intelligence, is already mind-boggling. Such potential will be further unlocked once 5G networks will become more pervasive. Conscious of these rapid developments, we are challenged to position Malta as a jurisdiction that is facilitating a friendly blockchain ecosystem. This is rather a new uncharted area that we are venturing in. And though we are constantly aspire of doing the right thing, we are not perfect. Hence the reason for engaging in effective consultation on matters that are of major impact on your industry. Having said that, delaying is not an option. And here we must be proactively in making or in being proactive is make or break in this area. In this context, the launch of consultation of the legal framework around the distributed ledger technology is only meant to serve this very purpose. As you might already know, such framework is set on three pillars. That is the setting up of the Malta Digital Innovation Authority, the creation of a framework that facilitates the voluntary registration of technology service providers and certification of DLT platforms, and the creation of new fintech products and players in the financial service industry. We firmly believe that these pillars will set in motion the next paradigm shift in our industry. If we are careful, the developments ensuing from this legislation will have the prospect to offer us countless opportunities. Although I do acknowledge that they will also pose challenges in equal measure, not least to find the required skilled human resources to sustain business operations. Therefore, from here, I wish to extend the government's pro-business stance by extending my invite to anyone wishing to be listed, because we know that optimal results are achieved if this journey is made together. To conclude, I must therefore thank the chairman of the Malta Communications Authority, Dr. Edward Woods, the management and staff of the same authority, for their sustained effort to promote and reward the achievement of the ICT in Malta across business and society at large. However, please permit me to thank once again the entrepreneurs present here today this evening, who through their investment, business acumen, vision, and above all, the relentless pursuit to innovate, have managed to distinguish themselves in these prestigious awards. I congratulate you all and augur you further success in your future endeavors. Thank you, and I wish you a pleasant evening.
Thank you, Honorable Silvio Schembri. So, ladies and gentlemen, this brings us to the end of the 7th edition of the MCA eBusiness Awards. We hope you enjoyed this evening as much as we did it. To all winners, may I invite them to come here on stage for a commemorative photo and a short interview, and to the rest of you and to the winners after, there are some refreshments just outside the hall. Thank you very much for being a wonderful audience. Good night.